Hello, my name is Michaela Barrett. I'm a product manager here at Microsoft. Today, I'll show you the latest and greatest with Microsoft Lists and document libraries. Let's get started with Lists. Lists help you track information and organize work. Last year, Lists got a visual refresh with updates like view tabs, filter pills, new column types, and performance improvements that are almost twice as fast. But the innovation did not stop there. We continue to make lists simple, smart, and flexible so you can stay on top of what matters most to you and your team. Let's take a look. My team is focused on the launch of a new product in 2025. As we count down to the launch moment in 134 days, a lot of issues keep popping up that we need to track, fix, and ensure they're completed on time. We use an issue tracker's lists. Now, one of the most important pieces of this list is having an easy way to log issues and get them into the list. With lists forms, I can easily create a new issues intake. I can add a custom logo, either for my company or the issue that I have. And then you'll see that not only do I limit myself to the rows and columns in the list, I can add new ones like the attachment field. With simple drag and dropping, I can reorder to be in the position that I want, and I can show and hide the different fields that are relevant. Now, I am super excited to show you brand new branching. When an item is critical, I want all the information. But when it's only a high priority or a normal or low priority, I can actually skip to the end of the form because I don't need all the same detail. Now, in this form, I can custom color to the theme that I want. I can have it notify me when it's sent, and I get to have a start date and an end date. So for my product launch, I'm going to have this form stop accepting responses when the launch already happens. And now I can customize the message that's sent whenever someone submits, and I can also customize the message when the form ends and stops accepting replies. Now, when I send this form, I'm actually going to walk you through what it looks like when this is pasted as if someone else was using it. So now when I load this form, you see the beautiful theming and logos, and I can add in my issue. Now notice when I make it critical, I have all these fields to fill in with the details I'm looking for. But when I switch to something that's normal, I only get the one additional field. I can submit this form and it'll appear in my list as if anyone on my team was doing it. This new item appears in my list, as you see here right on the top. But you also notice I have a lot of new items coming in. I've made a new view for the incoming issues that's filtered to new items, and I have it grouped by the different priority order. I can go into my grid mode to easily edit in line to assign the person that needs to fix this bug. I'm going to update it to triage since it's no longer new. I've taken a look at it, and I'm going to assign these in the priority order that they come in. But what would be really useful is seeing these items move through the progress, not just from new to triaged, but throughout the entire journey. I'm going to create a brand new board view, and I'm going to have the board view organized based on status so I can actually see the items as they shift towards completed. Now, when this loads, you'll see here that I have all the different columns where I can easily recognize where the fields appear. And I can drag and drop these between them, and they'll actually update the status of them. Now, in this blocked item, I'm not entirely sure if it's actually unblocked. So before I move it, I'm going to leave a comment to mark the owner here. And now what this is doing is at mentioning him, just like at mentions in Word, Excel, or PowerPoint. This will send Mark an email notification with my message, and it'll give him a direct link to this item, so that he can come in and quickly reply and update the status to let me know if it is indeed blocked or not. Now, all my new issues are assigned to an owner, but I want the new owners to be aware. I can create a rule to do this automatically so that I don't need to message everyone I assign these tasks to. I'm going to use a rule where I say if the assigned to column has anything in it, then I want to send an email to that assigned to person. I am so excited to show you that now you can add a custom message in that rule. So when that automation is triggered, the recipient will see your custom message and get a direct link to the item that they've been assigned to. This list is looking perfect for my team. But how easy is it to set all this up? Let me show you. The list create experience has more options than ever before to get started with a single click. First, you'll notice a brand new type of list you can create, a form, just like the one I made for collecting issues. You don't have to get started with a blank list, though. If you have something from Excel or an existing list, you could import it here. Now, I use the issue tracking template for the list I just showed you. But with over 18 out-of-the-box templates, it's easier than ever to get started. Now, lastly, you'll notice this From Organization template, where this is created from the Contoso IT department. Your company can create these out of the box so that your team can get started with something custom to you. Lists are a collaborative tool, and the number one place for collaboration is inside of teams. Everything I just showed you, from the board view to those custom forms, works exactly the same inside of teams. So regardless of where your team works, you have a consistent experience. And you'll see this item where I mentioned Mark before, but I want to send him a direct link since he hasn't replied. When I paste it into our chat, you'll notice that the link item unfurls and there's now a chicklet. And this chicklet interacts like a real item where I can copy the link, open it in the browser, or even kick off workflows directly from Teams chat. As part of this launch, my team needs to coordinate our communication strategy. We need to draft, review, approve everything from blog posts to budgets and social media campaigns. To do this, we use a document library. Document libraries are built on the List platform, so they offer secure, shared content management from any device, but with all the power I just showed you from Lists. Let's take a look. On my launch SharePoint site, I have a document library for all of the public communications we need to coordinate. You'll notice here that I have custom metadata that we know and love, like my status column with all the choice pills, my people column with the people face pile, all the way to the deadline for when this draft needs to turn into a finalized review that gets published. Now I can even go in and I can group this by the content owner so I can easily see what Mark owns versus what I own. I can go into grid view and quickly update and add this draft and add a deadline that I need it to be done by. And then similar to what we saw before, I can update the choice column to whatever status it needs to be in to keep my team on track. Now, to make everything super clear to my team, I want to configure formatting so that it's very obvious when something is approaching its deadline. I can go in and format my current view with conditional formatting. To build this rule, I'm going to edit it and configure if the deadline is before the new year, then I want to see the items that are not yet done, since it's getting a little close. And so if the status is not equal to finalized, and if the status is not equal to publicly posted, I would like to see these in red, since it means we're probably running a little bit late. So you can see here now, there's one item in my document library, the media budget, that is coming in a little close. It's still in review, even though it's due in 2 weeks. Now, my team works almost exclusively inside of Teams when it comes to the content management. So I can go into Teams and we'll see inside of my Contoso 2025 launch coordination, the document library looking exactly the same as it did before. I see the group by, I see the ability to format and highlight the things that I need, and it's consistent across all the different places that my team works. We're bringing Copilot magic to every place you interact with files, including your most collaborative and dynamic space, document libraries. Soon, you'll be able to hover on any file in a document library to access Copilot. From here, you can create an agent, ask a question, convert to a presentation, or dynamically create a FAQ grounded in that document. Or use my favorite feature, Summarize, to understand what this file is about without ever needing to open it. Copilot on document libraries is coming soon to you. Now, I am thrilled to share with you the biggest update in nearly a decade to document libraries. We are bringing together the power of lists with the refreshed visuals of OneDrive, making document libraries more flexible, faster, and easier to use. With view pills and a new navigation model, you can find the content you need in your large library unlike ever before, including single-click filters to pare down your content. We are bringing these experiences to where you collaborate the most, including SharePoint, OneDrive, and Teams channels. I have shown you just a sample of what's coming to SharePoint in lists and document libraries. Click the link below to learn more. I look forward to seeing how you use all these new features. Thanks for watching.